The Galaxy FE series always aimed to offer a flagship experience at a more affordable price. The S25 FE has a few improvements over the S24 FE. The most important one is weight. The Galaxy S24 FE is a hefty phone and weighs 213 grams, while the S25 FE weighs an impressive 190 grams. Even though they made the phones lighter, the screen size is the same. Both phones are using a 6.7-inch 120Hz display. Neither of the phones is LTPO, meaning the refresh rate is not in fact variable, unlike the more expensive S25 Plus model and Ultra model. One change is that the bezels are slightly smaller on the S25 FE now compared to the S24 FE, but you will only notice when you put them next to each other. The S25 FE comes in four colors, which are navy, icy blue, jet black, and white. I personally really dig the icy blue version this year. The S25 FE and S24 FE look almost identical design-wise. Maybe the only change is that now the frame of the S25 FE is made out of the same armor aluminum as we find on the S25 and S25 Plus. Also, the SIM card tray on the S25 FE is not on top anymore, and they now added it to the bottom of the phone, and that's how I differentiate which phone I'm holding. The rest looks similar, including the triple camera setup, and in fact, only the selfie camera is improved. The same camera module of 50 megapixel, f1.8, 1:1.57 inch, is being used. Basically, the same hardware you get on the phones like iPhone 16 and S25 base model. It is not a surprise that the photos with the main lens are looking identical with the same colors and details. The photos here are usually a little bit on the warmer tone, and when there are yellow lights in the scene, the white balance also shifts towards that. You can take 4K video up to 120 frames per second with the Galaxy S25 and Galaxy S24 FE. You can even bump the resolution to 8K if you want to, like the other Galaxy S series. For example, I took this 8K footage in Berlin for no particular reason. The ultra-wide camera is also unchanged. I did notice in this picture though that the colors are a bit different. The S24 FE colors are warmer than the S25 FE. Also, I noticed the white balance on the S24 FE has a bit of a shift to green. The same observation with this 3x photo and the phones regarding white balance. The telephoto lens is also unchanged. It is still a 8 megapixel one with a small sensor size. I really thought Samsung was going to upgrade this lens already, but they decided to stay with the same setup as last time. This telephoto sensor is rather small, so in low light situations like this one, I don't really recommend using it, and you are better off sticking with the main lens. The only real difference is the selfie camera, where instead of the old 10 megapixel one, there is now a new 12 megapixel camera, and it does offer better quality. You can also see in this video I took with the selfie camera that the S25 FE footage is noticeably better compared to the S24 FE. I know the camera comparison was limited. I'm currently busy with IFA, and I'll do a full camera comparison soon, so subscribe to not miss that video. For performance, the Galaxy S25 FE is sporting Exynos 2400, while the S24 FE is sporting an underclocked version of it called Exynos 2400E. I really thought that Samsung was going to use Exynos 2500 on this phone, and I'm surprised why they didn't. You can expect a very subtle performance boost from S24 FE to S25 FE, but that also comes with the cost of a slightly more power consumption. For thermals, they added a 10% larger vapor chamber, so that should in theory negate the higher clock rate for heating. I should put that to test later. They also use the same 8GB RAM. The charging speed is also improved. It is now supporting 45 watts instead of the old 25 watts charging speed. On top of that, they added a slightly higher battery capacity of 4900 instead of 4700. Overall, as you noticed, there is not a crazy amount of improvement for the new Galaxy FE series. So, does it make sense to buy the S25 FE over the S24 FE? In my opinion, it all comes down to two things. If you're like my auntie and care about the weight of the phone, then going for the S25 FE makes sense. The second thing is that, what's the price of the phones in your region? Sometimes you can get the FE for a crazy low price. If in your market, the phones are similarly priced, I would go for the S25 FE. Otherwise, the S24 FE is close enough, putting that weight aside. You can also go for something like the A56 if you want to spend even less money. If you want to see how the A56 compares to the Galaxy FE, watch this video next. Thanks for tuning into Techmo, and I will see you in the next one.